The off week is in the rear view. It's time for the Bobcats to attack the MAC. Hi, everybody. I'm Russ Eisenstein, the voice of the Ohio Bobcats. Monday night at Donato's in Athens, we were back with the Frank Solich Show. It's time to slice it all up for you now with the Solich Show Slice. Saturday in Akron, Ohio takes on the Zips. The Cats are 3-1. It's a MAC opener for the Cats. Akron is 1-4. They lost at Bowling Green this past Saturday. The Zips are improved. Tickets will be available. We hope to see you up there. But to get you ready for the ball game, let's hear what the head coach of the Bobcats had to say. It's our Solich Show Slice for week number 5. And I know it was a big week for your coaches to get out there and touch base with recruits that are coming in. That's another added value of off week within the season.
Yeah, definitely. The recruiting is ongoing. And any chance you get to get out and see coaches, high school coaches, and you know, we've got 16 commitments, and so we tried to get around to see everybody, and then those that we did not touch base with, we got to see at a game this past weekend, and so it's important to once you see one guy that you can keep rolling and do all that you can within that few days that you have to recruit. So our coaches hit the road. Did a great job, and we're off and running on next year's class, and I really, really like it. And I like last year's class in terms of what they're all about. We get nothing but great reports from our strength coaches on the work ethic of the freshmen this year. Get nothing but great reports from Jenny, who's in charge of our academic area, and so really a lot of good kids and really a lot of good athletes. And I think this next year's class is gonna be the same. And so, you know, I think we're getting better in terms of our recruiting and what we've been able to attract to Ohio.
First off, the offensive side of the football. What do you like? What don't you like?
I like the fact that we've had to get things done with a mixture of guys in the offensive line. We've had a lot of guys that are young guys, some of them first-year players, some of them second-year players, that are now playing multiple positions because of the injuries that we've had in the offensive line. So I really like the fact that a lot of those young guys are learning a lot of different positions and are supplying a lot of energy to this year's program right now, which means nothing but good things for down the road. I like the fact that our experienced quarterback is really playing well, you know, and Tyler's having an excellent season, and that's not automatic. You know, when you have a lot of success early on in your career, it's not automatic that one year leads to another great year and that year leads to another great year. And so really been pleased with what Tyler has gotten accomplished this year. And so we're bringing along a lot of young receivers. Our running backs were thrown in, Bo doesn't have to carry all the load that he's carried last year, which is good in that we were able to distribute that a little bit. Obviously, it hurts Bo's stats some, but in the long run, I think it's going to still prove out, in terms of his reps and what kind of production he's getting and bring another backs along also.
Defensively, what do you like? What don't you like?
Well, again, defensively, we're playing a lot of guys and playing a lot of young guys. I like the fact that our defensive line were able to, you know, last year our starters played the vast majority of the game. Mm-hmm. This year we're able to throw in a lot of different players, get a lot of reps to different guys so that there's energy at the end of the game. And so... I think that part of it's serving us very well. I think our corner situation has developed really, really well. You know, obviously Travis being a mainstay there with what he can get accomplished, and you look at Ian Wells and Devin Bass, how well both of those guys are playing. We're very solid there. We're getting good reps at the safety spot. So a lot of promising things happening with really a share of those guys being young guys.
You want to establish how you do things. So from that standpoint, how did year one go for you?
Yeah, I thought there was a lot of positives that we saw from last year in terms of just change of culture and getting certain systems established and getting guys to understand how we want to play and the effort level and the intensity we want them to play with. So I think they really wrapped their head around that. And, you know, we're excited about now the return of some of those players and then now the infusion of the new players that we brought into the program.
Frank Solich, your thoughts and a key for the game against the Zips.
Well, they're a very good football team despite their record and obviously dangerous. And, you know, we're going to it's going to be a game where offensively they are explosive on both the passing game and the running game. You know, Chisholm is a excellent runner for them and out of the tailback spot. You know, they've got really a good throwing quarterback, receivers. So we're going to have to stop a complete package from our defensive end of it. We need to win special teams. You know, that'll be a key in this ball game because both teams have got good offenses. Both teams have got good defensive. They're a strong physical football team. We got to match that.
Our network pregame show starts at 1 with the kick at 2. WOUC-FM 89.1 out of Cambridge will be where you can tune into our pregame show for the rest of your ride up to the Rubber City on Saturday. And there are a variety of smartphone apps where you can tune into our radio network call. Rob Cornelius, Grant Burkhart, and I will paint the picture of Ohio football and the Akron Zips coming up on Saturday. Thanks to Tanner Smith and Tony Ermain for their good work. For the coach Frank Solich and for head baseball coach Rob Smith, I'm Russ Eisenstein. This is Bobcat TV.